total eclipse in Madras, Oregon. As you can see right there, Jamie Ukas is watching it. Jamie, what's happening?
Anthony, I can't look away. I know we're about 2 minutes from totality, and everyone here just started cheering and clapping. It's a very primal moment, many people are saying. I'm with the mayor of Madras. His town is usually 6,200 people. It exploded to around 100,000, so people could go ahead and watch the eclipse. Mayor Royce and Banks, thank you so much for being with us. We really appreciate it. I know I want to keep the glasses on, too. Describe how you're feeling right now. First of all, the temperature's gotten cool. It's like twilight, and you have all these people watching.
I'm so excited. This is just really the thing that we've been planning for 3 years. And to have everybody here and everything running smoothly and people enjoying it, it's really worth it.
I want to keep talking to you, but let's put our glasses on and take a look up at the sky, because we are just moments away from totality. Of course, Oregon is the first of 12 states. You can hear the crowd starting to cheer. We're at Solar Town in Madras, Oregon, which has about 20,000 people in it. Mayor, you heard a couple years ago some scientists were booking out hotels.
Right.
About 325 hotel rooms were booked up. Then how did you start the planning?
The first thing we started planning was for safety. When we finally realized that we were going to have this event happen, we did some research and see how many people are Umberphiles, those that follow the eclipses.
And it was a lot.
It was a lot. So we started planning then, and we planned for safety, and that's where we started our structure of our plan, and we just evolved it into making sure we had all the amenities and that people would be safe and comfortable.
Mayor, you described it a few moments ago as this was starting to enter totality. You said this is a very primal event. We're starting to hear people cheer and scream. We are just moments away from the eclipse happening in totality. How are you feeling? I'm anxious right now.
I am too. I mean, as I'm looking at it, it's getting smaller and smaller, and pretty soon we'll see it, and the crowd noise is going it up. It's just amazing.
Wow. They keep saying they don't know how you're going to react, and I can tell you this crowd is very, very excited. Anthony, this is just incredible.
Yeah, it's gone.
It's gone. We're in darkness.
Oh.
Take off the glasses.
Look at the halo.
Oh, my goodness.
Look at that halo.
Wow.
Jamie Ukas, you've disappeared on television.
That is amazing.
Jamie Ukas has been eclipsed.
Spectacular.
It's even more beautiful than I thought it would be.
This is spectacular. Yeah, I don't think you and I have never experienced this before.
Never.
And you have about 2 minutes here in Oregon from start to finish, because we are tilted further away from the moon here in Oregon than you guys are in Carbondale, Illinois, Anthony. You guys get about 37 extra seconds than we do here in Madras, Oregon. But I have to tell you, you know, the city, the reason the city was picked was because it was going to have clear skies. This is absolutely incredible. If you look around, it's like a beautiful sunset. You can see Mount Jefferson behind me and some of the other Cascade Mountains in a smoky haze because they do have some wildfires burning, but it is incredibly beautiful here. People are oohing and aahing. I want to take just a second for people so you can hear their reactions here, Anthony. It's spectacular. As you're leading up to doing these stories, Anthony, I'm sure you heard as well, people describe if they've seen them before, just how everyone reacts in a different way. And I was feeling so anxious, like the mayor was, just to see this happen. And now to take it in, it's just breathtaking.
Even on television, it's stunning.
Chaos. Yes,
it really is.
Yeah. And the cheers and the oohs and the ahs. We had talked to a woman a little bit earlier who said, she was planning to start crying because she felt that this was such an emotional experience for her. And I think to be in a place like this, can you hear the car alarm? Apparently the car is excited about the eclipse as well to the left of us right now. It looks like we have a little bit of movement. I should probably put my glasses back on.
It's coming back.
It's coming back. It's like the sun's getting a bigger cheer.
Yeah.
There it comes. Here it comes.
So almost 100,000 people descended on this town in Madras, Oregon, usually a population of 6,200. On top of the traffic, fighting some of the lines in the grocery store, I think this was well worth all of that, for sure. that the payoff?
That's the payoff. I am so excited. And do you notice it's getting lighter up?
And warmer.
A little warmer, yeah.
It was very odd. As you're leading up into the eclipse itself, I will tell you, as you guys go to experience it, you start feeling a temperature drop, and they talk about that little bit of breeze. We saw some birds start flying around. It almost looks like twilight. It's an incredible experience, and I can't wait for the rest of the country to have that experience. And it's now moving at 2,237 miles an hour, so good luck to you.
Jamie, thank you. Bill Harwood, this never gets old, does it? How many of these have you seen?
No, this is number one, is a total eclipse. I am thrilled to death, though, to watch that video from Mattress, because it gives us a hint of what we're going to see here in just a few minutes. The moon is about, I'm guessing, 20-25% over the sun. It's viewed from right here in Carbondale. But man, looking at that corona coming out, the outer atmosphere of the sun around the edge of the moon, it doesn't get more spectacular.
Yeah, the reemergence.